Can you explain what is driving the third wave?
Yeah, so in April of 2021, we really do have a new enemy. And if you just look back, in March 2020, we had the standard COVID strain that we got under control through great community effort of testing, lab capacity, and case and contact management. We then had another surge, the second wave, heading into winter. And again, we're able to control this. But sadly, the virus changed, it mutated, and it is much more aggressive now. And the dominant strain in Ontario and in KFL&A is the B117 mutation. And it's got a couple of changes in it that makes it bind more strongly to the respiratory lining, so the back of your nose and throat, and get into your respiratory system more quickly and replicate more quickly. And as a result, it has a much higher death rate in Ontario, of 1.5 times higher. It is sadly having a significant effect on our hospital system and a 2 times higher risk of getting admitted to the intensive care unit. And we have over 800 Ontarians in the intensive care setting right now in Ontario, and our hospitalization rate has gone up as well. So we actually have the highest admissions to hospital, the highest ICU critical care use that we've ever had, and it's sadly it's because of this new enemy, the B117. It's also causing younger people to get sick. And in our hospital, from patients from within KFL&A, we have 2 in the ICU, 1 in the hospital, and all 3 of them are in their 50s. And sadly, it's causing even younger people to get ill. And we have 82 active cases. The vast majority now are from these variants of concern. It spreads more quickly, it's more virulent, and sadly is having a bigger impact on our healthcare system. So as a result, we've had to have the public measures put in play, and we'll have to wait and see throughout May whether those will have to be continued. We have plateaued in the orange area of the reopening of Ontario and are having trouble getting our case counts down just because this virus is so aggressive. Please try to limit your travel, stay within your household, maintain your masking and hand hygiene, and I think we'll be able to control this, limit its spread within KFL&A, but every time you leave our region, your risk goes up because there's more variants all over Ontario.